Lord.
Well, first, I want to say, on behalf of all the Crosswater men and women that serve in this ministry, we're so grateful that you guys allow us to come and to serve you. I have a strong connection to what you guys do. I'm a veteran myself, and stationed here at Fort Hood twice because it's the place that never lets you go, right? And you know, everything you guys do is special, and every one of you all matter. And this ministry that we take part in here, and you know, this SRU event is just one of the things that we do. This ministry is all about really a singular purpose. Everything we do is for a purpose that goes beyond anything that we've seen and done here. Open your ears. Everything we do. Okay, quick point. Oh, you want the Sergeant Major voice. All right. Everything we do in this ministry is for one single purpose. And that is because we want everyone that we come into contact to experience a new normal in their life that we've all experienced. And every one of us have a new normal because of a person. And that person is the Lord Jesus Christ. And that person came to us because we have a great God who loves us. And that's our goal. Make no mistake, that's why we take part in this. Because every one of these men and women that serve in this ministry have been touched by the love of God and Jesus Christ. And it is our hope to be his witnesses before anybody that would come before us, that we can proclaim his greatness and his hope. But here's the thing. I know there are some of you in this room right now that don't even know about God's love. Matter of fact, many of you, I know, have probably been taught by other people that God, even though they would say God is love, really, he's not motivated by his love. He's not seeking out by his love. But God is this evil taskmaster up in heaven who looks down on people who are messed up, and he's just eager to beat you down. He's eager to punish you, and we're lucky that we just can make an escape because Jesus come in our stead and takes the whooping for us. And the whole motivation of God is about punishment. How many of you guys have actually heard that kind of stuff? Yeah, no hands. I know there's some hands. That's all here to tell you. Sounds like a Sergeant Major, okay. But I'm going to tell you that's not the truth. I'm going to tell you that there is a new normal that everybody can have, and it's based off of God who is first and foremost motivated out of his love for each and every one of his image bearers. And I'm going to share just real quick, it'll be brief. How many of you guys know John 3:16? Everybody knows it. Recite it with me now. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever would believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. How many of you guys believe that? All right. But I bet you, most of you, even though we can state that verse just off the top of our head, many of us have not actually stopped and broke down that simple verse to understand what is actually being said. So I just want to take a few minutes today and prove to you that God is motivated out of a perfect love for you to provide perfectly for you in his Son. The verse very simply starts as Jesus is speaking to a man named Nicodemus who is seeking after the truth. And it starts with a very simple statement. For God, the beginning of all things begins with for God. Jesus is talking to Nicodemus, and Nicodemus thought that he was pursuing God. Nicodemus thought that he was chasing after God, but Jesus is teaching him right there that Nicodemus isn't chasing after God. God was chasing after him. And that's the first thing I want you to know, every single one of you, that God is coming after you. He is looking for you. And look, when you find that, when you are overtaken by his love and his grace, it is not because you went after something. It's because he, out of his love, has come after you. He is chasing down his image bearers to pour out his love. If any of us will finish this race and stand before God on that great day, we will not be able to say, I came after you. No, we will know full well that for God, he came after me. Then he continues, he said, for God so loved. Some people know God as a judge. This is what I just was talking about briefly. Some know God as just a creator. Some think that God is some untouchable ideal. But here, Jesus tells us something very simple, yet very profound. But God so loved. So loved. What is the motivation for what he is doing in the world? It is not hatred. It is not judgment. It is love. God is moved in his love. And then Jesus carry on. He says, for God so loved what? Good question. He said, for God so loved the world. Now, the word in the original language, that is cosmos, which means the entirety of his creation. God is motivated out of his love, and he loves his entire creation. Everything. That means you. You were created. You were knitted in your mother's womb by a holy and glorious God who loves you and wants to redeem you and wants to rescue you from the very things that lead you astray and lead you in destruction. For God so loved the world. But it gets even better. For God so loved the world. Well, we might say, well, okay, so what? But it says, for God so loved the world that he gave. You see, God's love isn't just an ideal. God's love isn't just an emotion. God doesn't just love in some ooky, you know, squishy way. No, God's love is an action. And God's love draws him to give. It motivates him to give. This isn't a picture of God waiting around for people to be good. This isn't a picture of a God waiting around for us to get it together. This is a picture of a God that out of his love makes the initiative to go and to love. But then we might ask, well, what is the manner in which God has loved? And Jesus says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son. He gave his son. He sent his son on a rescue mission to rescue sinners from the power of sin, the power of death, and the power of the enemy, that they may be free and have a new life. A new life. This is the love of God, the perfect love of God, who looks upon people who are almost, look, I am tore up from the floor up. I don't have it together. But the one thing I do know is that I have a God who sought me, and a God who bought me, and a God who made me his own. And if I, as I look forward to that future day, when I stand before the throne of God, the only thing that I will be able to boast in is that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. But now here, you might stand and go, okay, well, that's great for you. But here's where the rubber meets the road. That God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so that whoever would believe in him, who would simply trust in him, not whoever would get it all together, not whoever would fix themselves, not whoever would look pretty, not whoever would have it all, have everything lined out, not whoever could put away all the sin issues and just live that perfect life. No, whoever would believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. That's the hope that we have. See, friends, God is not looking for good people. God is seeking out people that are mired in ugliness and disparity, and he's loving them with the gift of his son, saying, won't you just come and trust in my son, in the provision of my son, and you will be reconciled to me, and you will begin a new life in Christ. So here's my prayer for you, and I'm going to do it. If you don't know Jesus, don't waste one more day. And you don't have to have it all figured out, y'all. Look, I've been following Jesus for quite a long time. I'm older than, well, not older than some of these guys.
It's our mayor not here. Yeah.
And I still don't have it together. I still learn. Every day I learn more about God's love and his perfection seeking after me. So you don't have to have it together. And if you're sitting here right now and you're thinking, yeah, but God doesn't know the nastiness that's in my mind. And yes, he does. And guess what? He loves you anyway. And he's chasing after you with his son anyway. So can I get all the Crosswater men and stand up, please? I'm going to speak for them because I know it. You look around this room right now. If anybody in this room needs to know more about this Jesus Christ, if anybody needs to talk to somebody about this gospel and how you might come to know Jesus, you go find any of these men, and I guarantee they will not chase you away. They will sit down. And now here's what I promise. If we don't have an answer to the question, we will find it, and we will get back to you.
That's right.
But please don't wait one more day, because for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so that whoever would believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for the gift of your son, that you have chased after us in your perfect love, that you have sought after us as your apostle Paul says that you proved your love for us in this, that while we were still sinners, while we were still dead in our sins, Christ died for us. And that we were not people chasing after you, Lord. As your word says in Ephesians 2, that we were people chasing after the world, we were people chasing after the flesh, that we were even people that were worthy of your wrath. But even as we were dead in those sins, you came to us in Jesus Christ. And Lord, I pray today that you would chase down more tonight. That you would lead those to trust in your son and to see a new life that is ready for them. A life that will challenge them, but a life that will also fulfill them. And I thank you, for I know that your word will never return void, but it will always accomplish what you intend. I ask all these things in the most holy name of Jesus.